kind of made a promise that if I did get this building, that I would make sure that I would give the building back to the people. And it would be used as a neighborhood, purposeful place. I started finding paints everywhere. So I started picking up paintbrushes and coming up with this design and that design. All over Randyland, you're gonna see the chairs and the piece of stone that's down there on that table. Those doors were old doors from the neighborhood. The map now is a teacher map for children and for also adults. So it's not just for the neighborhood in the city of Pittsburgh, but now it's for education. So Randyland is a house of recycling and repurposing. It's all about what I find. All the people that come in, they walk through the gate, they go, wow! Well, their reaction is my reaction. We get sometimes 200 kids a week. I've been in the yard sometimes where there's been 20, 30 kids playing in the sand pile. I'm not an artist, by the way. I know nothing about painting, but I do know that I wanted to make this place joyful, happy, and colorful. I don't get inspiration by touring or by seeing the world. I just get it from home sweet home. This is crazy, but people from every country of the world come here. I always ask, why are you here? And they say, because there's nothing like this in our country or the world. People are saying it's the most painted house in the world. So this is a new trophy for Pittsburgh. Randyland is not just a walk through a gallery. It creates happiness for so many people, and that is the joy that if you're happy in your heart, then you will find that you're richer than most people's pockets. And that's what Randyland has done for me.